We want to welcome our viewers to our program, Living with Love, a broadcast of the Global Mission Ministries.
We bring you greetings in the powerful name of Jesus Christ, the name that is above every name. The Bible says God has highly exalted Jesus, and he has given him the name that is above every name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. I'm so glad to have with me Reverend Dr. Christopher Salina and his wife, Joanna Salina.
Good to be here.
Thank you, Pastor Charles.
I have known this dear couple for over 22 years. Pastor Salina and Sister Joanna Salina, they are president and founder of Jesus Restoration Ministries International. They have traveled together over 36 nations of the world. Presently, they are missionary to South Africa. They are doing mission work over there. What is mission work? Mission work is telling about Jesus. The greatest missionary is Jesus Christ, who was sent by God with a mission. The Bible says Jesus came to save and seek those who are lost, according to Luke chapter 19 and verse number 10. Pastor, would you please tell us what you are doing in South Africa?
Well, first of all, Pastor Charles, it took 17 years of prayer before this became a reality. 17 years, my wife and I prayed, the Lord showed us that one day we will be on the African continent. And the Lord orchestrated it so beautifully that one day when I was heading to Pakistan again in Germany, the Lord spoke to me when I was fasting for 3 days and three nights. That he wanted me to go to South Africa.
Praise God.
And I came back from Germany, shared with my wife, and I made my first journey to South Africa in 1999 of November. I was invited there to minister for 7 days, and we had a wonderful time ministering with a dear lady that had a great encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ. After this experience of 7 days in South Africa, where souls were saved, lives were transformed,
Hallelujah.
And bodies were healed by the power and the presence of the Holy Spirit, I came back to New Jersey and shared with my wife. The Lord had put in my heart that we need to go back to South Africa. And my wife went into prayer. And she said, if the Lord showed you that as a family we need to go there, we need to pray some more because I need to get confirmation on this.
Amen. Amen.
This was very important to her that she got confirmation from the Lord. And she began to seek the Lord, and through the scripture, through the word, and through godly counsel, and then God began to arrange circumstances,
sure.
Present circumstances that we were in, that were basically pushing us in that direction. So with all the circumstantial evidence, she began to receive the peace of God inside of her. And then we begin to see the provision of God being poured into our lives and family to go in that direction. And I believe the peace of God took over, and we were ready to head towards South Africa.
And God speak. He confirmed his word. We have peace in our lives. And God put all the pieces of puzzle together. It's very important when God speak to you, you wait for the confirmation. You wait for his peace. And friends, I want to tell you, maybe you are in a process of making decision. Maybe you are heading for mission field or anything else. Wait for God's peace, confirmation, and sure, he will do it. Sister Joanna, please.
Yes, it was important that I went in prayer to seek the Lord for 3 days. And I was quite shocked about our going to South Africa. So I just went before the Lord and said, Lord, if it's in your will and your plan for us to be in South Africa, then you must show me as you showed my husband. And I knew there needed to be that unity and that agreement. So I sought the Lord for 3 days. And by the end of the third day, I had this peace to go and visit for a few months. So we went and we visited for a few months. And during my time there, my heart just began to be filled with love and compassion for the people there. And I just felt like we were at home. And I knew that God would have us return to work there for another 8 years. He didn't tell me 8 years. I thought we were going for 2 or 3 years.
Mm-hmm.
But it turned out that we stayed there for 8 years. And it was quite a mission experience. The culture, just learning about the people and the language was quite a challenge and a blessing at the same time.
Wonderful.
Amen.
Thank you. Pastor, tell us, what are you doing over there in the area of spiritual life of people?
Well, it's almost like the initials of my name, CTS.
I see.
Christopher Troy Salina,
mm-hmm.
a disciple of CTS, Christ the Savior.
Amen.
CTS, we call people through evangelism, 10 crusades. We call them, we have crusades. We work with a very important covering, Dr. Graham Weber, who has a 2,000-seat tent. We go into areas and we work with pastors to invite souls from the community. We call the tent the Jesus tent.
Amen.
No other human being's name is on that tent. It's the Jesus tent.
It's a beautiful name.
And the pastors in the area will preach under that tent at least once a night.
So you're doing evangelism, telling people about Jesus. What else you're doing?
And we would also have community ministry where the needs of the people will be found out.
I believe you are also training the locals through seminars and teaching in the Bible college.
That is correct, and we would also have a time for couples because we know there is a great attack on the family. Great attack. So we place great emphasis on the marriage and the family.
And you are also doing church planting, Pastor, over there?
Church planting and also the little tents.
I see.
That come out of the Jesus tent where in villages a small tent will be given to a local pastor to start a church, and that tent would seat about 100 people.
Amen.
That would be provided, a tent with 100 chairs, and the work of God would start.
Hmm. Evangelism, telling about Jesus. The Bible says that Jesus is the Savior of the world. Jesus said, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. That's evangelism. You must know the way. You must know the truth. And the Bible says, you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free. And Jesus is the life. He gives you life to have life, and life in abundance. Sister, tell us, what is the area of your ministry over there in South Africa?
Well, one of the areas of ministry, Pastor Charles, was that one of the local churches there asked us to be part of a free clinic that they were about to open for the community. And I began so excited because I thought evangelism, we could have Hindus and Muslims and different people come, and who would not come regular to the Sunday service. But they began to come, and we checked their blood pressure and checked them for diabetes, and also we checked their eyes, you know, to see if they needed eyeglasses. Mm-hmm. And it was a great way of reaching out to the community, to people of all different nationalities and religion.
Beautiful.
And God really made that a blessing, and I participated with that for 2 years.
Wonderful, wonderful. And I got to know that you started a rehab center called House of Hope. What a beautiful name. I love it. Please tell us something about this.
Pastor Charles, this was started in 2001. A widow woman provided a piece of property to one of the local pastors who we worked with. And they called us in and asked us, are we willing to do something with this property? God had already prepared our heart before leaving the United States to start a House of Hope.
I see.
So again, the circumstances pushed us into this direction. We started out, it was a 4-bedroom house.
Okay.
And we used 3 of the bedrooms for men. Men coming off the streets. Men thrown out of their home because their families could not put up with the addiction anymore.
Sure.
And we started with about close to 15 men.
Okay.
So there were bunk beds. And then we had house parents that came from Kenya. And they would stay on the property. And we would gather together and just worship God, teach the men to worship God.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Because they were worshiping other things. Mm-hmm. And they were in bondage. And once they learned how to worship the Lord for a whole hour, there was such a freedom in their lives because they were connected back to the God who created them for worship.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And many of them would look forward for that first hour session before we get into teaching them how to be free and how to be set free.
Hmm.
And one of the scriptures that was paramount was Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus
Hallelujah.
Of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all those that were oppressed of the devil,
Amen.
For God was with him. So we had the worship, we had the word, and then the witness of the power of God setting the captives free. And this became almost, I hate to use the word normal, but we were expecting God, after we worship and the word, to see a witness of his power amongst these men.
Amen. So as you hear,
that started in 2001, Pastor.
I see.
And 700 men have gone through the program to date.
I see.
And the Lord is using that work so much to reach young people. That somebody has now blessed the work there. A local ministry has taken it over, and it has expanded tremendously.
Wonderful. So, as you hear, Salina family was doing mission work over there in South Africa, evangelizing the nation, training the locals so that they would reach out to people, plan new churches, and they were doing social and humanitarian work to touch lives. Because Jesus saved people, Jesus healed people. He meet the needs of people. What are the needs, Pastor, over there?
Right now across the Umsloti River, where we planted a church, the property is taken over now. the church is still functioning under a Zulu woman that my wife mentored. She's now the pastor with a group working around her from a local church. But a big part of the ministry now, which is carried on by Ruth Grobler, is rescuing abandoned babies. Many babies have gone through there. And I would like my wife to share, especially on that ministry.
Please. Seneca Kelly Children's Ministry in Durban, South Africa. A widow with a couple of teenagers had a burden to take in abandoned babies. Of course, they call it a home for children. And many, many babies have gone through that ministry, have been adopted by Christian families. And we're just so blessed to be a part of, because the property was formerly owned by us personally, and we were able to sell it to a abandoned baby ministry. And Ruth Grobler has been doing such a wonderful ministry there among the Zulu people. Lots of these babies were abandoned even in parks. Some of them, mothers, you know, gave birth and they were left in maybe shoe boxes in the park. So they were found by other children and brought there. So God is really doing a great job with that ministry among the children. And we thank God for being a part of it.
Wonderful. Amen. We are glad to hear. Now we want to pray for the nation of South Africa. God has a plan for every person on this planet. God doesn't want anyone to perish, but everyone to come to the saving knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Especially, we are going to pray for South Africa. We are going to pray for our missionaries who are there, working hard for so many years, that God would continue to bless their ministry. Let's pray. Pastor, would you kindly lead us?
Father, we thank you for the opportunity to share with the viewers and the families. As they view, Lord, we pray for the Holy Spirit, the most important person on the planet,
thank you,
to move on hearts of people,
yes,
to be given a burden to intercede for the nation of South Africa. That the Holy Spirit would move across that land, upon the government, upon the nation. That God, you would touch South Africa once again. We're in need of a mighty move of the Holy Spirit in that land. That the poor would be picked up out of the dunghill and put into places that would make a difference in that nation. That the churches would be set on fire by the power of the Holy Spirit. From town to town, from village to village, even in the mountains where a particular woman, Ruth Twala, is working up in the mountains, Father, of Mapumulu, that God, there will be a mighty revival even upon that mountain as she seeks to do greater works that you have promised to do through her in accordance with John 14:12. So we bless South Africa on this program today in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name,
amen.
God bless you. Always remember, Jesus loves you. God has great plan for your life. He wants to touch your life. Give your life to Jesus. Amen.
The song of the redeemed, rising from the African plain. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out the Amazon rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire. tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah. He reigns, he reigns. It's all God's children singing glory, glory, hallelujah. He reigns, he reigns. Let it rise above the four winds, caught up in the heavenly sound. Praises echo from the towers of cathedrals to the faithful gathered underground. Of all the songs sung from the dawn of creation, some were meant to persist. Of all the bells rung from a thousand steeples, none rings truer than this.
Of LA, an old man lies in his car.
just in eyes. He looks up to heaven and prays a prayer. Is there anyone there? You know his name and you hear his cry. The rich man's gate.
Information, contact us at gmministry@gmail.com or visit us at www.globalmissionministry.org.